गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर सोशल स्टडीज क्लास विथ हिस्ट्री चैप्टर नंबर 3, द देन सल्तनत। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आफ्टर PT1 टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर ऑनलाइन क्लास एंड यू नो दैट वी ऑलरेडी फिनिश्ड चैप्टर नंबर 1, 2, and 4 इन हिस्ट्री एंड नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर चैप्टर नंबर 3। इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द दिल्ली सल्तनत, टिल व्हेन टू व्हेन दिल्ली सल्तनत वाज देयर इन द किंगडम रूल, लाइक वी कैन से दैट टाइमिंग इज हियर 1600 AD to 1526 AD, मींस वी कैन से दैट नियर बाय 320 इयर्स दिल्ली सल्तनत टाइम पीरियड विल बी देयर। एंड इन दिस चैप्टर नाउ वी विल टॉक अबाउट मैनी डायनेस्टी ऑल्सो, मैनी किंगडम्स ऑल्सो। लेट्स बिगिन दिस चैप्टर। द पीरियड बिटवीन AD 1206 and AD 1526 इज नोन एज द पीरियड ऑफ दिल्ली सुल्तान इन द हिस्ट्री ऑफ इंडिया। मीन्स दिस टाइम पीरियड इज नोन एज दिल्ली सुल्तान टाइम पीरियड बिकॉज ऑन दैट टाइम दिल्ली वॉज कॉन्कर्ड बाय सुल्तान एंड दे रूल एट दिस प्लेस। You have already read in the second chapter that Muhammad Qori defeated Prithviraj Chauhan in the second battle of Tarai. Already we discussed in second chapter how he defeated Prithviraj Chauhan in second battle with his army, which laid the foundation of Muslim rule. Means with defeatation of Prithviraj Chauhan, that Muslim rule came to rule in India on that time in Delhi. The Delhi Sultanat got established. Henceforth, the rule of Delhi Sultanat can be divided into 5 distinct periods on the basis of dynastic rule. If we talk about dynastic rule, then we can say that that type of time period, that type of Delhi Sultanat time is divided into 5 distinct time periods. Like Muhammad Qori's sudden death in 1206 resulted in a tussle for supremacy among his generals. After the death of Muhammad Qori, a question is there, who will be rule? But no one know that he already decided Qutbuddin Aibak, who had already been, we can say that deputed as the Viceroy General of that dynasty, proclaimed the Sultan and ruled from Delhi. This led the foundation of the slave dynasty. Means with Qutbuddin Aibak's rule, slave dynasty began to start to rule. And subcontinent for about 84 years, means after 84 years, slave dynasty came to rule. The slave dynasty is called so because the rulers were slave before they rose to ruling position. Means till they get the rank of king, they were only slave of kings. Slave means we can say that workers, servants of that kings. Sources of the Sultanate period. How we know that all that things, all those facts about Sultanate period, then we can say that many type of facts we have today. According to that, we can say that things were true on that time. We have both literary as well as archaeological sources to know that the Sultanate period. However, the accounts of travelers and court chronicles and the most valuable. Many type of things we have, like travelogues, court chronicles, and many type of literary sources also we have. According to that, we can say that all that things and all that facts was true only. Ibn Battuta and Marco Polo visited India and wrote about the condition during the time. Many travelers came to India, like we can say that Ibn Battuta, Marco Polo, Ziauddin Barani, Shamse Siraj Afif, and Minhaj Us-Sirah have given a detailed account of court proceedings and details about the personal and public life of the Sultan. He mentioned everything, all these travelers mentioned everything about their rules, their lives, king's lives, people's lives, common people's lives, all that thing discussed by them in their travelogues. Coins, inscriptions and monuments are the other important sources that tells us about this period, and we can see that many type of other historical sources, historical facts and literary terms, and many type of things were there on that time. According to that, we can say that when Sultanate period is start and when the Sultanate period was finished. The slave dynasty. At first we will talk about the slave dynasty. You know that, and I already mentioned that after the death of Muhammad Qori, slave dynasty came to rule. The rulers of this dynasty were called slave or Mamluk sultans. The rulers of this dynasty were known as Mamluk sultans. Actually, Mamluk in Arabic means own. Means they became the king as own self only. Iltutmish and Balban were slaves of Qutbuddin Aibak. Iltutmish and Balban both were slaves of Qutubuddin Aibak, who himself was the slave of Muhammad Ghori. Means Qutubuddin Aibak also himself slave of Muhammad Ghori. Muhammad Ghori slave is who? Qutubuddin Aibak. Qutubuddin Aibak slave who? Iltutmish and Babur. Now we will talk about Qutubuddin Aibak, who ruled from 1206 to 1210. The first ruler of the dynasty was Qutubuddin Aibak. Muhammad Ghori had left him in charge of the territories he had conquered in India. Means whatever he can, he gave supremacy to Qutubuddin Aibak. You have to rule after me. After Ghori's death, Qutubuddin began to rule as independent ruler. Qutubuddin was a kind-hearted and generous man. He was kind-hearted person. So he was known as Lakh, Bucks and many other names also being there, because he gave away a lack of charity. He always worked for the public foundations and the welfare of the human beings, and that type of things was done by him. After that, Iltutmish started to rule from 1211 and ruled till 1236. Means we can say that nearby 25 years he ruled. Qutubuddin was succeeded by Iltutmish. Means we can say that after the death of Qutubuddin Aibak, Iltutmish started to rule. He is considered the real founder of the Sultanate. If anyone asks you who was the real founder of Sultanate, then you can say that Iltutmish. Iltutmish faced many problems but dealt with them strongly. He put down the rebellions within the empire. He also protected the northwest frontiers of the Sultanate against possible Mongol invasion. In the east, he expanded his empire up to Bengal. In west, we can say that he expanded his empire till Assam, and if we talk about east, then we can say that till Bengal his empire was there. Since no son of Iltutmish was efficient enough to become his successor, means he knew that his son was not able to become a successor, so he decided to make his daughter as a successor, whose name was Razia Sultan. But nobles of that time were not agreed with this policy, because they know that if a king had a son, then he had to make them rule. But Iltutmish was not happy with that. Because of that, he made Razia Sultan as a sultan. The nobles were unhappy with this choice. After the death of Iltutmish, they placed Ruknuddin Firoz Shah. Whenever Iltutmish died, the nobles start to make any type of disputes, and after that they made Ruknuddin Firoz Shah as a sultan, a son of Iltutmish, on the throne. Ruknuddin spent his time enjoying himself. He was a sultan, but he is not behaving like a sultan, because he was only a puppet of the nobles' hand. And Razia, with the support of the people of the city, became the ruler, and again people decide to make Razia Sultan as a sultan. Razia Sultan started to rule from 1236 and ruled till 1240. Means we can say that nearby 4 years she ruled. Razia could not rule for a long period after the death of Razia and till the accession of Balban. Many kings came to the throne of them. Nasiruddin Muhammad, another son of Iltutmish, ruled from 1246 to 1266. Another son of Iltutmish came to rule after Razia's death, and he ruled nearby 20 years, but he was puppet of the nobles' hand, so he was also not successful on that time. Now Ghayasuddin Balban started to rule from 1266 to 1286, means nearby 20 years. Balban got the throne of Delhi in 1266. He was the most powerful ruler of the slave dynasty. If anyone asks you who was the powerful ruler of slave dynasty, then you can surely say that Ghayasuddin Balban. He had been an important noble since the reign of Iltutmish and was the real power behind Nasiruddin Mahmud. Balban reorganized and strengthened the army. He fought against the local rulers and defeated many of them. He fought with many rulers and he defeated also them rulers, and he also guarded the northwestern borders against the Mongol raids. Balban wanted to people to look to the Sultan. He introduced the Persian custom system and Babos and Jamin. And it was his biggest mistake, we can say that, because Babos, Sita and Jamin Bos, all this type of the customs were belong to God only, and he wanted to use that type of customs for himself only. Because of that, he is going to be fed. Balban's successors were weak. In 1290, the Khalsi nobles captured the throne of Delhi, and because of that Balban's wrong policy, that Khalsi dynasty is going to be start and slave dynasty began end. Now we will talk about the Khalsi dynasty. Dear students, now we will talk about Khalsi dynasty. The Khalsi dynasty was founded by Jalaluddin Firoz Khalsi. The Khalsi dynasty remained in power for 3 decades, means till 30 years. Jalaluddin Firoz Khalsi ruled from 1292 to 1296, means nearby 6 years. Jalaluddin Firoz Khalsi was a great warrior in his youth, but when he ascended the throne, he had become very old. He adopted a lenient policy towards the Mongols and married one of his daughter to Uluk Khan. It is his biggest plus point. Because of that, Mongol became big in front of him. The Mongol leader Jalaluddin was succeeded by his nephew Ali Busab, who took the title of Alauddin. Means after Jalaluddin Firoz Khalsi, Alauddin Khalsi started to rule from 1296 to 1360. He ruled the most powerful ruler of Khalsi dynasty. We can say that a powerful ruler of Khalsi dynasty was Alauddin Khalsi. He was an ambitious ruler. Soon after coming to power, he set about his goal to establishing an old India empire. Because means he want to escape all India and he want to rule on complete India. Expansion of his empire, means we can say that with the time he is going to expand his kingdom. Alauddin conquered Gujarat and Malwa. This gave him control over the western seaports between 1301 and 1303. He campaigned in Rajasthan and captured the forts of Ranthambore and Chittor from the Rajputs. Thereafter, he sent a large army towards to south under his trusted general Malik Kafur. Means we can say that from Delhi to he start to ride nearby southern coast, and whenever he start his travel from Delhi, he start to capture all the fort from Rajputs. And finally, we can say that he sent his trusted general, we can say that Malik Kafur, to south. Malik Kafur defeated Yadavas, Kakatiyas, Hoysalas and Pandyas. He also carried away a lot of war booty, including precious metals, elephants, horses and slaves. He not only taking that type of the acquisition from that kings, he loot that type of thing, likes the all metals and whatever they got, they take from that dynasty. The kings so defeated were allowed to continue as rulers, but they had to pay tributes of Alauddin and acknowledge his overlords. And towards the end of Alauddin's reign, his empire was as large as the king's Ashoka. We can say that his empire was as large as Ashoka's empire. To keep such a large army, Alauddin Khalsi needed a lot of money. We can say that. And we can understand also, if you want to handle a large army, then you want much money for that thing. A lot of money you need. Land revenue was the most important source. Alauddin made many reforms to increase tax collection. Means he know that only land collection he had, and according to that only he can get all that things. After that economic reforms, Alauddin Khalsi got all the cultivated land, measured the fall in his territory and categorizing them according to fertility. The land tax is known as kharaz, was fixed accordingly. Means according to fertility, that type of tax is fixed from the peasants. To get more money, Alauddin raised the land tax in the Dob region, means whichever region is known as fertile region, like the, we can say the Ganga region and Yamuna region, nearby that river area. That place charged much money from that peasant. He kept a strict check to nobles who did not allow them to collect additional taxes, to check the officers and discourage corruption. Alauddin also introduced a system of getting the accounts of his officers audited. This system was later followed by Sher Shah and Akbar. We can say that many of the policies of Alauddin Khalsi was followed by Sher Shah and Akbar also. Alauddin also introduced a market control policy. It was his biggest policy. We can say that Alauddin Khalsi's biggest policy was market control policy, and in this policy he decided about the Delhi grocery item, means the essential items charges he fixed, that prices fixed by him, and they have to, shopkeeper have to sell that type of things on a fixed and lower prices. And if any type of shopkeeper is find that he is taking much money from peasant or anyone else like common people, then he will be surely punished. That type of policy was there on that time. And why he made that type of policy? There is the biggest reason for that, because he had a large army, and all of the army need essential items for survive. And if that type of item, that type of essential item will be available on low rates, then he also have to give, we can say that only few money for that servants, or as a salary, he have to give only few rupees. The rates fixed by Sultan, he also appointed some officials also and shop owners, whoever was caught charging even a little extra or cheating the weights was punished severely. This idea was making goods cheaper and was probably introduced because Alauddin Khalji wanted to pay his soldiers a low salary. Means he wanted to pay a low salary, because of that he started market policy. And the policies of Alauddin Khalji made many people poor. Because of that, many shopkeepers became poor, and that type of policy was, we can say that, most famous policy in the Indian history. After that, reforms in the army, the revenue reforms of Alauddin made more money available to him. With that money, he was able to maintain a large standing army, and he paid his soldier in cash. He started branding horses to the one substitution, good horses by inferior ones. A full description for each soldier was also kept. Means soldier was given full of facilities like chaira and horses, and all that type of things is given to them. And after Alauddin's death, a war of succession broke out. The last Khalji ruler was Khusrow Malik. Dear students, it is we can say that about Khalji dynasty, and after the Khusrow Malik that was defeated by Ghayasuddin, we can say that Tughlaq, and with this only Khalji dynasty start to finish, sorry, became end their rule, and with this Tughlaq dynasty start to rule. Dear students, I hope you understand this both dynasties, and if you have any type of doubt, then surely you can ask through Google Meet class. Thank you so much.